Here, we will look at a scenario-based question in the Security Plus SY0-601. The question is targeted to Objective 3.3, given a scenario, implement secure network design. We're using the advanced features in the Windows Defender Firewall with advanced security to configure an inbound rule based on the requirements indicated in the question text, which reads, create a custom firewall rule in Windows Defender Firewall with advanced security to allow SFTP connections on your private network, TCP port 22, from only IPv4 address 10.0.0.194 to this PC. Name the rule SFTP. After reading the question, you can break it down to the primary points that need to be addressed. You begin in the new inbound rule wizard. Here, we will choose custom as the rule type called for in your instructions. This will allow you the ability to create a flexible rule that supports your requirements. Most users utilize a third-party app for file transfers, and since no program has been specified, we allow all programs to ensure compatibility. Next, we choose the TCP protocol based on its reliability and dependability versus UDP. Now, we choose specific ports and set port 22 for the local and remote ports, as it is the default port for SFTP. Using the same port numbers for both devices will eliminate problems with mismatched ports. The scope screen defines how the rule will be applied. The local IP address is not defined, which makes any IP address the correct choice. Configure the remote IP address per the instructions. Choose these IP addresses and click Add. In the IP address pop-up, enter the IP address 10.0.0.194 that the rule will be applied to and follow the prompts. Your next choice is to allow the connection. Then, apply the rule to only the private network as specified in the question by deselecting the domain and public network types. Name the rule SFTP and click Finish and submit your response. The actual CompTIA test requires that you submit your response when you've completed a task. The CertBlaster follows the same procedure. In both cases, if you don't submit the response, your work will be lost. You'll see a confirmation of your submission. Finally, you can review your work by using the Answer button in the navigation bar. A pop-up will show you if you are correct and show the correct steps. The upper section of the CertBlaster screen displays the navigation features along with the exam or drill you're taking, and the exam objective covered.